Kimi no Na wa, or just your name in English. This entrancing movie is a love story filled with courage and perseverance, all centered around one concept. An old East Asian myth traveled down from generations to generations. There's this ancient legend revolved around the single red string. Legend says this crimson thread connects those who are destined to meet, regardless of time, place, and circumstance. When they meet, they will one day create history together, making their own special mark on the canvas of our earth. This thread may stretch or tangle, twist or turn in a million ways, but it will never break. This legend is among one of my favorites because I choose to view it at a different point than most others. In most stories, this legend is used to represent that one generic type of romance recognized from all over the world. The cheesy, lovey-dovey boy-girl stereotypical relationship. You know what I'm talking about. It's in so many movies. My theory is that this legend can and should be used to apply to other forms of love, not necessarily that one type. Yep, that's right. I'm sure none of you adults like here today were expecting a 14-year-old girl in the 8th grade to lecture you on love. Okay, I would like everyone to participate in an activity with me that will point out the quite obvious. Raise your hand if you are single and currently not in any sort of romantic relationship. Okay, yeah, that's a decent amount of people. Now, out of these people, keep your hand raised. Out of these people, keep your hand raised if you love someone dearly in your life. So, we can obviously see that people love in many different ways. You probably already knew this, but let's dig a little deeper into my idea. Some concepts I will be touching on are platonic relations, family relations, and our different preferences for people. Everyone's love is different. Your love is really unique to only you. For example, some of us may like taking things slow and building strong bonds, while others may feel like being fast-paced is the ideal way to approach love. We also can't forget about our dear friends, platonic love and family love. As children, these two types of bonding are what we depended on for survival. And frankly, I don't see any problem depending on them throughout adulthood. Sometimes, a platonic relationship is far more fitting and convenient. It all really just comes down to what type of person you are. I like to see this red thread of fate as something with different textures and different sizes, each unique to what you want and love. Finally, our preferences in people are also very diverse. Some of us may prefer tall over short, maybe like lively over quiet, black over blonde hair, girls over guys, which we will get more into later, and many more. In the end, whoever you choose should not be solely based on your race, religion, or family. You shouldn't let these aspects keep you from loving a best friend or even a suitor. So, I'm sure you are all very familiar with the ever-so-popular LGBTQ+ movement. Along with this movement, more ideas and types of love came through the perspective of different people. Guys who love guys. Girls who love girls. This revolutionary act is just one example of how our preferences for people are not limited to just personality and looks. All these types of love are what makes each human unparalleled in our world of 7 billion people, eventually leading to each person choosing their own path to fulfill their own wishes and desires. Before I conclude things, there is one more critical point I must acknowledge. Whatever path we decide to walk down, whatever decisions or preferences we decide to make, we must do the right thing and respect one another. Criticizing someone based on their own love life is unjust. We should be able to freely follow our red strings, freely walk our desired paths, without rude glances or hurtful words. actions you may partake in will never cut nor damage someone's scarlet red yarn. When you walk down your road, I'm sure you'll find a way to the end of your red string. Whatever that may be is completely up to you. But know that within the labyrinth of the past, there's only one thread of fate tying you to someone unique, to only you. Unique in a world of 7 billion people. Unique in our Earth's deep, rich history. Unique to your own emotional concept of love.